So where you at?
This is Kansas City, Missouri, or Kansas City, Kansas. I'm not really sure which. Anyway, we're here today at the City Market, which is a farmer's market. It is Saturday morning. It's nearly 8 o'clock. There's a guy over here playing the saxophone.
Yeah, he's playing the sax. Where is he? Oh, there he is, right there.
Yes.
Yeah.
And the market is this way. We're going to go that and see way. What kind of things they have here.
I can't hear you.
I don't know what to do.
You're doing good, though.
Things they have here at the market. What's fresh this morning? We're going to find some breakfast while we're here as well. So come with us so you can see, you know, what Kansas City has to offer. Statues of different animals, which is unusual. You don't really see that in your typical farmer's market. There's always your popcorn guy. Somebody's always selling kettle corn. We have your lemonade and limeade food truck. We also pass by fresh pasta. I think it's fresh pasta. Well, it's homemade or recently made. It's not store-bought pasta.
As far as you know.
Yeah, we pass by somebody who cuts up mangoes for you, and you just pull off the pieces of the mangoes and it's on a stick, and it looked really, really inviting. Could you imagine like juicy mango dripping down your face and your
Did you
arms?
Want some of that?
Not really.
You're naming stuff that I did not get on camera.
Oh.
So now I gotta go back and
now
get it.
Now you gotta go get
it. Now I gotta
roll.
Go back
yes,
and get
it. It's all my
on camera.
Fault. Shame on me.
I just wanted to know what city we in, and where that's all I wanted to know, because we got the city landscape in the back.
Yes, it's great.
So we're in Kansas or Missouri, at somebody's farm market.
At the City Market.
City Market.
Yes.
Which is basically a farmer's market.
It's basically a farmer's
But they call market. It a city.
Why don't you do this interview?
You want to try the vineyard? We'll try a beignet in Kansas City. We'll taste
All
it
right,
too.
So we're getting an apple cinnamon beignet, and this is Louisiana swamp juice.
You gonna try
Mango,
it?
Mango, apple, grape, lemon, and seasonal fruits.
You gonna try
it?
Yeah, okay, you gonna try it. What does it taste like?
I taste a lot of grape juice.
Oh, okay.
And then at the end is a bit of nectar, mango nectar.
Mango nectar,
yeah.
Okay.
This is the apple cinnamon beignet. We got it from, I'm not sure what the name of this place is. Beignet at City Market.
Okay, okay. So
in Kansas City.
Oh, the apple's oozing out on the side over
is
there.
Is it?
Yeah.
All right, so that means I got nothing in this bite.
Yep, it's all oozing out on this side.
Well, here, that is free. No, I don't want to give you the joke of it.
Ooh,
oh, yeah.
Yeah.
You see that? You see that ooze action?
Is it hot?
Yes, it's hot.
You want to let it cool off?
There you are. All right.
It's like taking forever to take a bite.
Okay.
You like it?
It's hot, it's crunchy, it's powdery, and the powdery sugar on top. It's really good.
You sound like those people.
Doughy. Right? Yeah.
The Food Network. Describing the food.
That's what, I mean, in hindsight, that's what you want to know, right?
Yeah.
So you can give it a try. Come on, try it. We walked a whopping 2 blocks. We're a little winded.
It was uphill. It was uphill, see?
Yeah.
Uphill.
Yeah. Anyway, we found the homesteader. This was recommended by our host at Airbnb, the Minty Manor.
Yeah.
Daniel and...
I don't know.
Anyway, they suggested this was a good place for breakfast, and so here we are. This is the Homesteader Cafe. And supposedly they have really good chocolate beignets. We already had a beignet, so we'll probably not get that again. But it looks pretty quiet. It is Saturday morning.
Oh Lord, I can't get my focus right.
But it looks really quiet, so we're gonna check out the menu and see what we think about having actual breakfast there. If not, plan B is ask a local. This is Benta Watkins reporting from Kansas City, Missouri, or Kansas.
Okay. Miss Whisper.
So the funny thing is, we come in here and there's probably six people in here already seated. The rest of the place is empty. The lady asks us to have a reservation, and we're like, nobody's in here. What are you talking about? Anyway, we come in, we sit down. We have our one server and a trainer, and we order our breakfast. I wanted a farmer's breakfast. It sounded good. Eggs, potatoes, bacon. Really wanted pancakes, but was talked into biscuits and gravy. Biscuits and gravy were actually good. It was actually one biscuit with a lot of gravy. Anyway, asked for a second biscuit. Charged me $2 for one extra biscuit. Crazy, huh? Anyway, Williams' breakfast was fine. He didn't eat all of it.
So what do you think? I mean,
it was fine. I mean, it wasn't blow your socks off fantastic. I mean, it was your basic breakfast.
Okay. So
next time
we'll scale, your scale fine is like what?
Oh, all right. So on the scale of 1 to 5,
fine
this is like
means
3.5.
Okay.
Would we come back if we stayed an extra day?
No. Server was good, though.
She was fine.
Service was good.
Yes. William had to beg for water. That wasn't good.
Server was all right. She had a good personality.
She was very tall.
So food was...
It was fine.
Okay. Service, like, better, you know, adequate.
It was
doable. But generally, if I don't have to ask for water and they fill it up without me asking, I think that's...
Especially since it's not busy.
Yeah, so... But, you know, what is the name of this place again?
This is the Homesteader Cafe.
Yes. So far this market compared to ones that you've been to, what would you give this?
Well, I think the neat thing about this market is the little shops around the edges for people, so the market is sort of an extension of what they have inside. I think that's really unique quality about this one. Also, I've never seen fresh spices before or fresh tea where you can buy it by the scoop. We just bought lots of different kinds of tea, not even sure what kinds. I know peppermint, we started there. I got a tropical green tea. We got a peach green tea, which sounded and smelled so good.
Mm.
Overall, it was about $2 a scoop for rib rub, or they had the Kansas City rub. It had ginger, cinnamon sticks, garlic powder, anything you could think of. It had, you could get a scoop of fresh spice. The guy said he ground it up every morning, him and his cousin, I think he said. And you could get all the spices you need for whatever meal you decide to make with the things fresh from the farmer's market.
So from your scale, one to...
My scale? Gosh, we've been to a few. I'm not sure. What was my favorite one? This one is pretty high ranking.
Scale of 1 to 10.
1 to 10. Oh, that's tough. I'm a big fan of the Des Moines market because it was so big and it went for several blocks. So that's probably my number one. This may be number 2.